One of the most interesting musical compositional techniques is called a fugue, and so few times has it ever been used in film. Today I want to talk about film music with fugues. But to talk about fugues, we need to go back to what a fugue is. And earlier on, the term kind of had lots of different meanings. But one of the meanings that started developed happened around the time of Bach. We're talking about 1750, or a little earlier there, because that's when he died. And there were forms of fugues called ricercare and other types of musical stylings. But I want to be really clear here, because this is where it really makes a whole lot of sense of what the difference is. There was something that Bach wrote called a toccata and fugue, which is a touch piece for the performer, meaning it was difficult on the fingers, difficult on the performer. And then there was this fugue. And here's where the difference comes in. A fugue is showing off what a composer can do with musical tones. A toccata showed off what a performer could do with the notes written for them and the virtuosity of it all. One of the most famous ones is a toccata and fugue used in Disney's Fantasia. Let's take a listen to this for a minute. That is the kind of general idea of the differences between what a fugue might be. All right, let's define it a bit more. With Bach, the Well-Tempered Clavier, he had written basically a fugue and a prelude for every key in the musical system twice in two different books. Then later on, he developed it a little bit more with the Art of the Fugue, and the Art of the Fugue is a much more developed, here's one theme, and I want to show you what a canon is, and these kind of things. So again, what is a fugue? All right, so a fugue is a theme, which was called a subject, that gets repeated in a higher voice, and which would be, I guess, a refrain. It would be the same thing, just in a higher or lower voice. And a counter theme would be written around it. It's a counterpunctal type of idea. Then once you get a texture of maybe three different counterpunctal themes, you would have a development section, and then you would have a coda, or a return of these themes. All of this is what kind of builds what a fugue is. After Bach's death, the technique of writing a fugue became less in vogue. Mozart, Beethoven, and later in the Romantic period, Franz Liszt, also wrote fugues, but it just was less popular as a style or a type of technique to use for composers and listeners. So, how many film scores have a fugue? Well, the answer is none. Absolutely none. There's fugal moments. There's counterpunctal moments that are fugal. The most popular fugue in film music is John Williams' Shark Cage Fugue from Jaws. Now, this is not a strict fugue. It presents a theme, a subject. It presents a counter theme or a counter subject. It has interludes. It has some development, but it is definitely not a fugue. It just has the overall sheen of it. Now, John Williams has done this a few times. In Home Alone, there's fugal moments. And I guess that's what I want to say, is that film music is fugal moments. Jerry Goldsmith in Patton and in the Blue Max had fugal moments. Bernard Herrmann in Psycho has a fugal moment. There's no thing where everything gets developed. It's just kind of a theme that gets repeated in a upper or lower voice and a counter theme. So it's like it gets started, but no development happens. Same with Alex North's Spartacus. There is a theme that gets presented, and then there are layers of counterpoint that happen, but there is no actual fugue. There's a couple other fugal moments that happen in film scores. In Howard Shore's The Aviator, the main title has a fugal moment. But I want to focus on one particular fugue I found in a film called Them by Bronislav Kapier. He did a really cool fugue for the ants. Let's take a listen. I know it's the most developed fugue that I could find in film music. There's lots of fugal moments. There's lots of fugal sections, counterpunctal sections where you've got a subject that might get repeated in a refrain with a counter subject, and maybe there's a third layer of counterpoint. But rarely, rarely does there ever a moment where music gets developed. And what that means is that the theme gets inverted or the theme gets played backwards. There are many things that happen in a Bach fugue that is a huge lesson to composers on the game of tones. I know that sounds funny, but really part of this life as a composer is playing with music and how the play of these different aspects of what you can do with the themes. You can always play it backwards. You can play it upside down. You can play it inverted. You can do all kinds of different variations to these themes. And Bach's Art of the Fugue and Bach's Well-Tempered Clavier particularly really shows the well-known ways of manipulating these themes. And with that, I would like to end this video. I hope you enjoyed the discussion on the fugue and how it relates to film music. If you like this video, please click on the like button. If you want to subscribe, come back next week for another video on film music